If you've been confused by people telling you what's better to shut off the computer or just leave it on 24/7 to avoid unnecessary wear and tear as well as slow boot times, then this video is something you're going to want to listen to. I'll explain the difference of shutting down the computer versus restarting it and what the problems are that you may not be aware of with not shutting the computer down ever. So this coming up. So first off, if you find my videos helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't. It really helps me out with making it all worthwhile to keep making more helpful tutorials for you guys. So let's dive in. There are some different myths and truths about shutting down or leaving the computer on, and I'm going to explain what these differences are and help you be able to make the right decision for you for any given situation. So the first thing is leaving the computer on because it just takes too long to boot up. Well, first off, if waiting 2 minutes is too long for you to wait for the computer to finish booting up and running all the services and background startup items that you have set to run, then you might want to look at upgrading to a solid state drive or SSD. That option would be a whole lot better than just leaving it on all the time, and I'll explain why that is in a little bit. The other thing is if your computer takes a lot longer than 2 minutes to boot up, then there could be some other underlying issues that you need to address. There could be an issue with the hard drive that's dying, or there could be some software conflicts. A virus or a hacker could even be in your system. So there's a lot of different reasons why it could be slow, and it's probably something you should be looking at rather than just avoiding that and leaving the computer on and turning a blind eye. The third thing is increased wear and tear by having to shut the computer off and on every day. That's a bit of a myth, because as long as the computer is on, unless it's gone into a deep hibernation and turns off the hard drive, it's actually running 24/7. And when it does go to hibernate, it does need to write files back to the drive to have it ready to start back up again and continue where it left off. So, in essence, leaving the computer on 24/7 isn't helping you to reduce the wear and tear. If anything, it's increasing the wear and tear because it has to write more to the drive to save it from memory to the drive so that when you wake it up, it continues where it left off. Versus when you shut it down, it just clears the memory and you're able to start everything fresh again. So now that you know that you're not doing your computer any favors by leaving it on 24/7, let me explain the risks and benefits about leaving the computer on versus turning it off. Firstly, it helps to understand the difference between turning your computer off versus restarting it. So when you turn the computer off, the next time when you turn it on, it goes through a post or a power on self-test. And what that does, depending on the motherboard and the manufacturer that you have, it will run a series of short tests on the hard drive, the CPU, the memory, and just test everything out and make sure everything's working properly and there's no obvious signs of problems. If you're restarting a computer, it just restarts it to apply updates and changes that happened. It clears out the memory and allows it to look for new updates. So if you're having a problem with the computer, a lot of times just restarting it will fix things because it flushes out the memory, gives all the programs in the system a chance to reset and clear itself again. But if the issue is something more hardware related, then physically powering the computer off and leaving it off for a bit and turn it back on can help. Also, to take it a step further, if you're having problems where a reboot or just shutting it off and on doesn't help, then try powering it off, pulling the power cord out of the back of the unit, as well as any USB devices. Just unplug everything to make sure that there's nothing else giving or taking power from it, and leave it all unplugged for at least a half an hour. And in addition to that, you can press the power button a few times to just make sure that you flush any residual power out of the system. nothing will happen. Most likely you won't see any light flash or anything. There might be a quick light flash just to show that there was a little bit of residual power in there, but that's it. Don't expect to see anything happen because everything's unplugged. We're just flushing the system. After a half an hour, plug everything back in and you can turn it back on. If that doesn't solve the issue, then you're going to need to get an expert to look at the system and troubleshoot the hardware first, make sure the hardware is fine. Assuming the hardware is okay, then they have to look at the software for any software conflicts. So that gets a little bit outside the scope of this video, but let's look at the next thing here of Windows updates and other program updates. You would not be getting any further updates in a lot of cases until you restart the computer. It can apply the updates that were just downloaded and installed before it goes looking for the next set of updates. So if you're never restarting it, the computer may eventually prompt you to restart, saying that it's been a while, we're going to force you to restart, so you got to schedule a time. Especially with Windows 10, they're pretty good about that. But the thing is, if you're waiting for that to happen, you're already a bit too far behind. So the next time you turn it back on, you'd have to force it to go check in for updates and then reboot the computer, go back to check for updates again, and repeat that process over and over until there's no more updates remaining. You might be thinking, well, with the updates part of it, who cares? I got a good antivirus firewall, why should I care about that? Well, an antivirus firewall are useless when it comes to hackers. They're looking at vulnerabilities in the programs that they can exploit and then from there gain access to your computer. So the vulnerabilities are patched with updates like Windows updates and other program updates for the various programs that you have installed in your computer. That's why you need to check for updates regularly on all the programs, not just the operating system, and rebooting the computer so that it has a chance to make sure all those updates are applied properly and it's ready to check and install additional updates. Quick poll here, how often do you shut down your computer? Let me know in the comments below. So in conclusion, I basically recommend that you shut the computer off at the end of every day. You're saving on wear and tear on the computer. If there's any power blips, power surges, anything like that, you're going to be less at risk with the computer crashing or getting additional damage done to it. Nobody can hack into your computer when it's off. And you're making sure that it's doing a reboot with the shutdown, so it's applying updates, and it's also doing the post to check the hardware when it first turns on. So unless you have a need to have the computer left on overnight where you're doing a very lengthy download or upload, or you have something else running that you need to keep on for the next day, or maybe you remotely access your computer so you need to have it left on 24/7, then in a case like that, you can leave the computer on 24/7 because you have a need for it, but get in the habit to schedule a reboot at least once a week, ideally twice a week, so that it has a chance to check for other updates, apply them, and get ready to download the next set. So that's it for this video. Thanks so much for staying through to the end. Give it a thumbs up if you haven't already. Subscribe if you haven't. It really helps me to make continuing to make more of these tutorials for you guys. All right, thanks so much, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.